Lagos is a beautiful city. A city of possibilities. Lagos is the smallest Nigerian state in size, but arguably the most populous. It is a major financial hub in Africa with unarguably the highest GDP on the West African coast. Lagos houses one of the largest and busiest ports on the continent. Its economic prosperity attracts all and sundry. Statistics shows that at every 5 minutes, at least 2,000 people enter Lagos on a daily basis from different borders. But not many of these visitors return to their states after their first visit. They all want to share from the prosperity of a city whose economic stream never runs dry. In 1991, Lagos' population was about 5.2 million. Today, more than 20 million people live here. In just 25 years, the population has grown four times its size. This makes Lagos one of the fastest growing megacities in the world. One interesting thing is that almost every family in Nigeria is represented in Lagos State. Lagos City Metropolitan Transport Authority says Lagosians make at least 22 million trips daily. With these mind-blowing facts, managing Lagos City and maintaining its place of excellence does not come easy. The city must remain clean. Jobs must be created, lives and property must be secured, vehicular traffic must flow, schools must be built, and other essential services must be provided. The Lagos State government is always on its toes. Since Governor Akinwumi Ambode assumed office in 2015, Lagos has not done badly in the area of security. Last November, the state government donated security equipment worth 4.8 billion naira to the state police command. In May this year, another security equipment valued at 1.85 billion naira was added. This makes securing Lagos one of the biggest investments of the Governor Akinwumi Ambode administration in the last 1 year.
7 months after, I'm here to find out what has really changed in terms of security and, of course, other issues in Lagos.
Steve Ayorinde is the Lagos State Commissioner for Information and Strategy. He was a guest on the last episode of Inside Lagos last year. Inside Lagos crew decided to engage him again. We wanted to know how safe is Lagos after the record donation to the police.
Hello, sir.
We arranged earlier in the week to meet at the State House and take a trip round the Center of Excellence.
Yeah, it's 3 minutes before we come. 3 minutes. Okay. All right.
We met at the State House football pitch where the governor's helipad is located.
All right, hi Captain, how are you?
We met Captain Gibson Villanueva, a Filipino pilot who has been living in Lagos for almost 10 years, and Apirio Goromse, the first officer on the helicopter.
I've been flying since 1980.
1980?
So, 36 years. Then I'm here almost 10 years.
Thank you so much, sir.
All right. Okay.
We'll be flying in this Airbus helicopter, 5NRRS. It is one of the three helicopters donated to the Lagos Command of the Nigerian Police Force. I had never flown in a chopper before. At first, I was a bit nervous. Boarding the aircraft was a moment of reality. The commissioner took the lead and we followed.
I think I'll go in first. Okay. All right. Thank you.
At the edge.
The pilots did their routine checks and off we went. Right now, we are flying thousands of feet above sea level. This is an aerial view of the city of Lagos. Its beauty is without a shadow of a doubt.
Are you okay?
I'm okay.
No phobia for the heights. Take it easy, just swallow your saliva.
Okay.
I guess my fears disappeared the higher we climbed. So we got started.
Okay, we are going through Oshodi, from Oshodi to Apapa now.
To Apapa, yeah.
That's our route.
Yes.
And I want to know why Governor Umiambode is investing on security. This is because he inaugurated security improvements on November 27th, last year, 2015.
Yes.
And he came up with another step.
Six months down the line. Yeah.
Why?
Because nothing will work. Everything will have amounted to naught if security is not top-notch. The first responsibility of every responsible government is to secure the life and property of the citizenry. It is a constitutional right that is enshrined in the Nigerian constitution. It is the duty of the governor as the chief security officer of the state to ensure that the state is livable, the state is safe, the state is secure, before we can start to talk about cleanliness and prosperity. Prosperity cannot come where there's no safety. Prosperity will not stay where you have kidnappings, where you have killings, where you have kidnappers, where you have terrorists. So Governor Kumiambade is giving us his best shot to say that this is the fifth largest economy in Africa. And therefore, in order to sustain that and to continue to improve on the profile of Lagos State, a Lagos State whose IGR totals more than those of 32 other countries in Nigeria, deserves every security concern, every security plan that the governor is giving to it.
I want to know how it has helped in improving security of Lagos State.
A lot. It has improved security a lot. I mean, people tell us that are we trying to be like Brazil? And we say to them that we're not trying to be like Brazil. The traffic situation in Brazil, in Sao Paulo and Brasilia, is so bad that there are more than 400 helicopter taxis moving people from point A to B. Those who couldn't stand the traffic. But the traffic in Lagos is not that bad. It's not anywhere close to that because through Governor Ambode's intervention in the last 1 year, we have seen that, you know, more roads have been constructed, rehabilitated. But then when you have good traffic, the issue of security also plays an important role, which is actually the whole point of this patrol helicopters. We used to have two, and now we have three, courtesy of Governor Kumiambode. And the whole idea is to add to the layer of safety and rescue operations in Lagos State. So these helicopters are useful in crime combating as well as in rescue operations.
Okay, what have we really achieved with it?
Yes.
With this air surveillance?
Essentially, it is surveillance.
Yes.
You remember, for example, when the Korodu girls were kidnapped. Absolutely. The helicopters were immediately deployed. The same thing last Friday when there were skirmishes and a bit of killings in the Korodu area. These are security things that we need not be flogging every now and then, but they are there to be used. We have always deployed them. We will always use them. And because they are there, just like the gunboats patrolling the waterways, we are succeeding in sending a clear signal to every gang, to every armed robber, to every kidnapper, to every miscreant that Lagos State can come after you decisively.
Okay. Is there any plan to also increase the helicopters for air surveillance? We only have three in the state.
We would love to, but this is the first time that we will have three. We had two at a time, and you know that even the two that we had at the time, they were not fully deployed into air surveillance. But this is the first time that we are having three, and not only three, they are fully engaged in surveillance, in rescue operations, in security apparatus.
As we flew above the Atlantic City, I decided to ask about the projects.
Now we are approaching the Atlantic City. We are on the island now.
Yes.
What is the state of the Atlantic City now?
The core Atlantic City project is on course. It's a PPP project that the Lagos State government, endorsed. We believe that it will soon come on stream. They have their targets and they are clear about their goals. By the time Eco Atlantic City will be ready, we're talking of a brand new city, something close to Dubai. 250,000 Lagosians will be living there. Thousands and several thousands of jobs will be created. And you will have a city on the Atlantic that you can be proud of. So the work is ongoing. It is not Lagos State money, it is private investment, and this is good news to us, and we support it with our whole heart. Now you can see all the buildings coming up, work is going on simultaneously. Everywhere has been mapped out, all the streets are clear, all the roads have been laid, and don't forget that this was where we had the Lagos Marathon, our closing ceremony, so this place is opening up. It will open up, it will be a fantastic city, by the Atlantic Ocean. This is not our Atlantis, this is our Eco Atlantic City.
Okay, how far can this administration take this Atlantic City? How far can it take the Atlantic City?
The Eco Atlantic City project? Well, the governor can be directly involved. The job of the governor and his administration is to create the enabling environment for this sort of projects to continue, to thrive. When investors see that Lagos is calm, Lagos is safe, Lagos is secure, businesses are booming, it means that this sort of a project will go on without any hindrance. But don't forget that Eco Atlantic City is not the only project that is dear to our heart. The Lagos Smart City project is also coming. His Excellency the Governor was in Dubai 2 weeks ago with the Honorable Attorney General and the Special Advisor on Investment and Overseas Affairs to sign the MOU with the Dubai Holdings and the City of Dubai to recreate the first ever smart city in Africa. Dubai is well known for smart city projects. It has extended to Malta, it has extended to Kochi in India. Lagos will be the first where you will have another of such smart city where things will be wonderful, where life will be beautiful, where everything will work according to technology, where you will have schools and institutions, hospitals, roads and train services all linking the Eco Atlantic and linking other parts of Lagos with an airport not far from the smart city. So we say to Lagosians, we say to the whole world that a new Lagos is emerging thanks to Governor Akinwumi Ambode. A new city is coming in the Bejuleku, Lekki, called Eco Atlantic City, and Lagos will be able to rank and compare with any of its peers anywhere in the world.
Okay, this time we are in Lubiri now on the island.
Yes, you can see it down there. Absolutely.
Now tell me, what is going on with Lagos Homes?
Oh, Lagos Homes are on course.
Lagos Homes scheme?
Yes, scheme. They are on course. We needed to wait for a while to review what has been done, to assess authenticity of some of the claims. And you will see from what we have done so far that some that have been earmarked for sales have been sold already to those who qualify. A good chunk of them will go into the rent-to-own scheme, which was one of the things that Governor Akinwumi Ambode used to campaign. What is the point of asking junior civil servants or teachers or young journalists or traders to come and buy homes that they cannot afford? But if it is a rent-to-own scheme, as it is done elsewhere abroad, it means that what you will have been using as your rent becomes equity into you ultimately owning that property. And those sets of rent-to-own properties would soon, go to the deserved owner, while Ilubirin which is the biggest of them all, will soon be attended to. It will be given out to a private investor who will complete it and turn it around into a wonder by the sea. And you'll soon see what will happen to that place.
Flying above the Atlantic Ocean reminded me of water supply in Lagos State.
Well, water is a major area where we are aware that there's a challenge, and we're working very much on that. At the inception of this administration, we saw that we needed to clean up the water system. And by the water system, I mean the administration around the Water Corporation. A new managing director was brought on board from the United States of America. Everything that looked like act of sabotage, particularly in dispensing chemicals, procuring and dispensing chemicals, have been dealt with. So it's a new dawn for the Water Corporation in Lagos State. The supervising ministry, Ministry of Environment, is on top of the game. The new MD is in place, and we're trying to move from the 40% Lagosians that have access to pipe water to about 60-65 in the next 1.5 to 2 years. We're working very much on that. But first and foremost, let us ensure, which is what we are working on, that the 40% who have access to this water enjoy it to the best, you know, that we can deliver. And we're delivering on that promise.
We also talked about Medicare in Lagos State under Governor Akinwumi Ambode.
Just last week, the special advisor to the governor on primary health care, Dr. Onoduga, combed every primary health care center in Lagos State just to ascertain where they are, what needs to be done, how much more we need to pump into them. So it means that we're concerned. It means that we are eager to see improvement. And we have somebody who understands the system, together with the Commissioner for Health, you know, who can deliver. IEK House will roll back to life in due course because the contractor is being empowered to return to site and do that which is needful. But you also have to appreciate the fact that when you say that the primary health care centers and the mother and child health centers are being overwhelmed, it is because Lagos is about the only state that is working. It is not only our hospitals and healthcare centers that are being overwhelmed. Our road infrastructures are being overwhelmed, which is why we need to constantly build more roads. We need to constantly maintain them, because for every 28 states in Nigeria that does not work, Lagos is the fall guy. This is where they're coming to sell goods, to hibernate, you know, with colleagues, to come to school, to seek Medicare, even from neighboring West African countries. It is good to ask Lagos to do more. We will always want to do more, which is why we are trying. How about asking other states in particular to also begin to reinvent themselves? We believe that in about 2.5 years, when it will be ready, we will have put a complete end to the issue of people seeking Medicare abroad, at least for Lagos State citizens, including Lagos State government officials, because it will be a world-class medical facility.
The one year of Governor Ambode.
Yes, it is. In office.
I took the commissioner up on how Lagosians perceive Governor Akinwumi Ambode's administration.
Are you getting from the people?
Impressive. Commendable. Because part of what we do, particularly in our ministry, is not just to give information out, but to also take feedback to the government so that we can know where to improve upon, what people are seeing across demographics, those who are not so educated, those who are huge and large on social media, the elderly and the pensioners. It has been one commendation after the other. Of course, there are a whole load of other areas where we need to improve upon, but people are saying that in just 1 year, if you have been able to deliver like this, without any untoward showmanship, without without anybody acting like a stuntman, without overly dramatizing the achievements of the last 1 year, people are saying that they are glad that they have voted the son of a teacher who is a cerebral accountant, who understands how money works, who understands how to manage resources in Lagos State. They are full of appreciation to the governor, and we are happy that at least they are expressing that appreciation to us.
When you said that Governor Abode is a silent achiever, what kind of a person is he?
You have described him. He doesn't jump up from the rooftop to say this is what I've done. Remember that the last campaign message that was put out just before the election, more than 1 year ago, was the poster that said, "Let my experience work for you." 1 year after, we had about 8 lawmakers in Lagos reminding Lagosians of that poster of 1 year ago to say that, have you not seen now that his experience is working for you? That is Governor Ambode for you. He does not shout from the rooftop. He's a strategic thinker. He's a silent achiever. He's a consummate worker. You can almost say he's a workaholic, and he knows what he wants. His target is very clear: to develop Lagos, to make Lagos a world-class city-state, and we believe that he doesn't need to trumpet his achievements before the whole world can see and celebrate that this is one man that Lagos State deserves.
After more than 30 minutes of flying across Lagos, we headed back to the government house.
I hope you have had a good flight, seen beautiful Lagos.
As the helicopter landed, I asked Steve how soon Lagosians can start benefiting from the much talked about 25 billion naira employment trust fund initiative of the state government.
People say that the employment trust fund of Governor Akinwumi Ambode will end up in APC's members' hands. What would you have to say?
That will be unfounded. That's not true. I'll tell you how the employment trust fund will work. There is 6.2 billion every year out of the 25 billion earmarked for the 4 years. 6.2 billion will be made available to startup businesses. Either you want to revive a small business or you want to start one. Young entrepreneurs, people with bright ideas who can source funding from banks or other financial institutions. The key word is startup business or small enterprise to either revive it or to help you start it up.
How would they go about it? Ordinary man, ordinary person.
The modalities will soon be rolled out. What has been done is that the law has been established, has been passed. The first tranche has been made available. The chairman, and this is Omoigu Okairu, former FRS boss, and the committee have been put in place. Now they are at the rudimentary foundational stage, making sure that the wherewithal that they will require, is in place before they start disbursing. They will first have to identify those who need the money, and they will have to make an expression, publish things for people to apply. And those who will get the money will be something from 100,000 naira to about 1 million naira. Are you saying that the only people who will need that sort of amount to start businesses are only APC members or are only politicians? So I say to you that it is not true. In any case, is APC not the largest party in Lagos State? And therefore, those who will be beneficiaries may not necessarily be APC members, but those who will have voted Mr. Ambode, into government anyway, or those who have been already converted because they can see the good works that he's doing. So 6.2 billion every year, in our estimation, and as I said, the committee will soon, the trust fund will soon, you know, put out the modalities. We expect that about 300,000 direct beneficiaries that are Lagos residents will be chosen this year. And of course, there will be indirect beneficiaries of twice, if not thrice, the amount of the people that will get the money directly. Because if you're a barber or you're an artist and you employ one or two people or three, it means that those employees are also direct or are also indirect beneficiaries of the Employment Trust Fund. That's okay, what we're trying to do.
What's the interest rate?
It will be just about 1 to 2%. It is not meant to discourage people. It is just, it's meant for just administrative charges alone. But as I said, this, you know, will be made known to Lagosians by the time the committee is ready, and I believe that in a matter of weeks they will be ready for the announcement.
Thank you so much.
Anytime. It's always, you're welcome.
Up again on Inside Lagos.
I must confess, this is the scariest interview I have ever heard.
Is it a question of phobia or?
But many thanks to the pilots, they made it happen.
For the safe flight.
Oh, pleasure of buying you.
Thank you. And most especially you out there for watching this episode of Inside Lagos. I'm Adedoja. Salam Adin. See you next time. Bye-bye.